Moksha is zero karma state. No positive karma and no negative karma is moksha. If you have positive karma, you will have to take birth again to bhog the karma, to accept gifts from others. You might be born as a Hollywood celebrity, but then when that is exhausted, then you go back to ground zero, right? So, such a precise science behind moksha, but even then it requires some grace. Because there is no way to, for a human being, even through deepest meditations, you say, okay, 19.35 units of positive karma and 19.34999 units of negative karma, it's all balanced. Now I'm going to go moksha because I'm karmically neutral. Right? Very difficult calculation. If you have positive karma, you'll become a deity. If you have negative karma, you'll become a rakshas or an asur or a demon. If you have some mix, you'll become a human being. Right? So it's a full scale. And moksha is about destroying all sorts of karma. Reaching that level close to moksha while in the body. Right? Because while you are in the body, you will still have concepts. Because the body itself is a concept. Then obviously in the body you cannot achieve moksha, but when you leave the body, then some of these lightweight concepts will also shed off on your journey to moksha. So when death happens, between death, human death and moksha, there is still some journey that happens, which might not mean that you go to a certain heaven and stay, or you go to a certain light. It may happen within a few seconds of human time. But all those concepts also start getting broken because you prepared for the breaking of those concepts through your practice before your death. When the Buddha passed away, he went through multiple planes. He went to certain heavens and he went, worked out his karma in certain hells, and all that process happened within a matter of minutes. And then he achieved nirvana.